stay at quarantine less for one day, it can be done. And I will show you in this video. สวัสดีค่ะ and say hello from Bangkok, Thailand. สวัสดี Thailand. Nice to see you in my channel and I hope everyone has a great weekend. Today is Monday. And for the new friend who just meeting me first time also, say hello and welcome to our community. This channel, สวัสดี Thailand, giving you the more update about visa, anything about incoming to Thailand related about travel. In this video, as I mentioned, there is a way to reduce one day quarantine during your stay. So this is a tips, not a trick, okay? If you're planning to come to Thailand and stay in quarantine, either 7 day, 11 night or 15 night, this video is for you. So let's jump into it. Reduce one day quarantine, anything is we were talking about, this one is your landing time, is your arrival time. After the Royal Gazette already has been released and registered, how to calculate it, timing and the day for the tourists who enter Thailand. So the ASQ must be followed. Still better than before. Before, no matter what time you arrival, they were counting for you as day zero. That's why you have 11 nights instead of 10 nights. You have 15 nights instead of 14 nights. The way they're calculating the time of arrival will make the difference. So I will show you how. The ASQ will start to calculate it from your flight arrival times. They calculate like this. So if your flight arrival from after midnight, when I say after midnight, this means 1 minute after midnight, it already after midnight, okay? So if your flight arrive after midnight until 6 p.m. Let's say your flight arrive was 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m., 4 a.m., 8 a.m., 3 p.m., 4 p.m., until 6 p.m., they will calculate this as a day one. So you are not losing this one. They will calculate it as day one, okay? Opposite way, if your flight arrival time after 6 p.m. until midnight, let's say your flight arrival 6.05 p.m., 7 p.m., 8 p.m., 11 p.m., they will not calculate it as day one. They will calculate as zero. So you're losing that time, all right? But the hotel you have booked is 11 nights already, okay? That means they already cover your day already, all right? But what is a good thing? If your flight arrival at the first one, as I said, after midnight until 6 p.m., you will be eligible to stay only 10 nights, not 11 nights. But your package is 11 nights because they will not offer you 10 nights, okay? Your package is 11 nights. That means you will save one more night. Right, that's why you have this one. You save time also because stay in the same hotel for 10, 11 nights, that means, you know, you want to get out, so one day it make a difference. I mean, it's not big difference, but it make a difference. You can be free, you can go out to visit your family and, you know, to do your own thing, be free for one day earlier. Opposite, as I said, if you arrival after 6 p.m. until midnight, you will be stay at 11 night as before. This is just a little change. Before, they were not counting anything. Everything from the arrival, they were count as zero. Okay, they were not counting day one at all. But now they have the little change. Now the questions come up like, what about if I stay 10 nights, but I pay for 11 nights, so the hotel will not refund, okay? And you cannot get asking any refund because it already said at the beginning on the Royal Gazette already, the ASQ must follow this rule, and they already registered that the hotel got the right to not refund because they already put in the average. Some people maybe fly arrival time because when they're making the price of 11 nights, they already average of the cost because some people might get 10 nights, some people might get 11 nights. That's why they average the cost, the risk already. Because they involve the hospital, the nurse and car and everything. That's why it may be a little change. You will not get any refund, but you can leave early for one day. And the last thing is that when you're making the reservation for your flight, you must look at your arrival time also. But I know it's not just to making the flight is not just arrival time. They are concerned many factors. The price also, which airline, the price, and also the transit time, like Qatar Airways. Transit time is how long, you know. For example, if you want to compare Qatar Airways stop at Doha, transit time is what, 2-3 hours, and you compare the flight and Etihad, you know, it many factors, I understand. No one want to wait at transit time for a long hours, many hours, right? You want to get to destination as soon as possible. So I understand that it's not just arrival time, but if you have a chance, choice of to choose the similar airline and similar price, and the flight arrival time, it's big difference between one flight is arriving 1 a.m. and one flight arrival 7 p.m. Which one you will choose? Of course, you will choose arriving at 1 a.m. because you are not losing that day. This is what I mean, okay? But I know you have your own thing to choose. Your preferred airline, which airline you will use. And now you can share me your experience of the airlines also. Which airline have you used before and which airline that your favorite one? Because later on, we were talking about more sort of for travel also from to Thailand. Which airline, about airline, about hotel, about destination, attractions. Because this ASQ that I'm talking about now will be not forever, right? Because I will not talking about ASQ forever. We'll be talking about airline, we'll be talking about routing to coming, the best price, the promotion, which airline coming to Thailand, what is the promotion. This is all about in the future of this Sawatdee Thailand channel. Please consider to subscribe so you will not miss any of information related about travel to come to Thailand. Until then, and I see you again. Stay safe for everyone in my next video. Bye bye. Sawatdee ka.